Expensive laptops and monster PCs are staples of software development today. We use these machines to write, test, debug, and run code locally. But recently there's been a massive shift towards remote work in all walks of life. So why should developers be stuck on local machines? We're excited to announce that you can now effortlessly connect from anywhere in the world to a remote machine running a JetBrains IDE backend. You can work on a project hosted on that machine as seamlessly as if it were checked out locally. Get the full functionality of IntelliJ-based IDEs on any computer with all the processing happening on a powerful remote machine. Skip the hours of wasted time checking out code, setting up toolchains and downloading dependencies for a complex project. And avoid the security nightmare of a stolen laptop containing private source code. JetBrains tools empower you to develop how you want to, with workflows for local and now remote development. This new remote workflow is included with your existing subscription and available in select JetBrains IDEs, with more coming soon. Connecting to a ready-to-use environment takes seconds with an existing IDE, or you can install our new compact app, JetBrains Gateway. It launches the IDE backend on the remote server, starts the IDE client on your local computer, and establishes a secure connection between them. This way, you get all the CPU power you need from a remote machine delivered to your laptop seamlessly, with the extra security of not having to store source code locally. Let's see how it works. From the welcome page, you can connect to a new server via SSH, or connect to a dev environment managed by JetBrains Space. Here you can enter a host and username to quickly set up a new SSH connection. Gateway will connect to the server and look for available IDE backends. If the required IDE is not already installed, Gateway will download it from jetbrains.com. Before continuing, you must also provide a project directory for the IDE backend to open. But if you don't already have the project available, you can open a built-in terminal and clone the project. Clicking Next will download and install the IDE on the remote server, launch it and load the project. The IDE backend is now running as a headless service on the remote machine. Gateway now launches the JetBrains client locally, downloading it if it is not already cached. This is another lightweight app that provides the user interface for the remote IDE backend. At this point, JetBrains Client is running locally, but showing a project that is open on a remote machine. All language processing is happening on the remote server, but the user interface is local. Project settings are configurable, dependencies are downloaded, the project is indexed, and all existing JetBrains features become available. Files are opened in the editor with syntax highlighting, inspections, and code completion. Alt-Enter shows a list of actions and updates the file. You can run the project too, but remember that it runs on the remote server, so you need to use port forwarding to allow connecting from the local machine. When you've finished working, just close the client. You can quickly reconnect from the SSH page of Gateway. Click the link and the client will reconnect. So far, we've talked about connecting to an existing remote server, but how do you manage remote development for a team or an entire company? You want to spin up reproducible dev environments in seconds? Connect your IDE and start coding right away. Share standardized dev environments across your team to streamline the onboarding experience. Launch dev environments per branch or per code review, with up-to-date version control and dependencies already downloaded. To help you with all of this, we are proud to present Space Dev Environments, a new feature built into JetBrains Space, our all-in-one solution for the entire development pipeline. It makes it easy for teams to orchestrate and manage their dev environments as virtual machines running in the space cloud.
Let me show you how to work with dev environments in space. The idea is that your IDE runs in the space cloud and is always ready to go with up-to-date source code and indexes. In any space repository, you can click Open in IDE and select a branch or merge request that you want to work with. You can also pick the size of the virtual machine your dev environment will run in. Next, you can select the IDE that you want to work with and the version. I'll go with the default for our space organization here. You can speed up your dev environment creation with a warm-up script. You can use it to download and install project dependencies, index your project, and so on. You can also install additional tools in your dev environment with a custom Docker file or use the default one that Space provides. When you click Create, Space starts your dev environment and will open it when things are up and running. On your local machine, you're running a thin client that communicates with the full IDE backend in Space. You can do anything you would be able to do locally. You can explore your project, you can work with code and write codes, use navigation, run unit tests, and all that. You can even run Docker containers in your dev environments. Here's the MySQL container that I need to work on this particular application. It's also possible to run your application in the dev environments and even to set up port forwarding so you can test web applications or API backends. Dev environments support your typical development workflow. You can create new branches and then use the Git tooling in IntelliJ to push them back to space. If you want, you can continue working in your dev environment, but let's switch back to space for a moment. In space, you can manage your dev environments. After 30 minutes of inactivity, the environment will automatically hibernate, but you can also do this manually if you want to. You can also create multiple development environments if needed, and you can restart and open them at any time.
We hope you enjoyed this short overview of the JetBrains approach to remote development. You can try it for yourself in your JetBrains IDE, or you can head to jetbrains.com/remote-development to learn more.